Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. I am Nitin Sama and today in this video we are going to discuss about synchronous versus asynchronous. Actually guys, we all know that Node.js is famous just because of its asynchronous behavior. But sometimes we have to do synchronously work as well. So guys, now we will understand what's the difference between synchronous and asynchronous, and at the what time we have to use synchronous methods and at what time we have to use asynchronous. And also we will learn that how we can deal with both of the methods. So guys, in my last videos, I've just created one video using the FS module synchronously, and in the second video I have used the FS module asynchronously. I hope guys you have watched them carefully. If you have not watched them, so I will request you to go there and watch them carefully. So guys, now I will provide the link of these particular videos in my description box as well, just for your convenience. So guys, now let's start. Actually guys, I have just created a blank folder, sync versus async. So I will create a new file, index.js. Yes guys, so now if you have watched my previous videos, so you may be aware about the file system module fs. So I will just require it, require fs. Yes guys, I've just required it, and now I will just write a file, write file sync, and I will just pass the file name, that is test.txt, and then I will pass the data, what data I want to write in the particular file. Welcome to Stubborn Developers guys. So I've just used fs.yaml, I've just used fs.write file sync. Maybe guys you may be aware because of in my previous videos of synchronization I have just used it. So I will go to the command prompt guys, then I will run my program. Node space file name, yes file, yes I will go to the directory. As you can see guys, test.txt file is created and it is showing me the data, welcome to Stubborn Developers. So guys, I have just created this test.txt file just to understand the difference between synchronous and asynchronous. Okay, so guys, now let's start. I will just make a command. Yes, I have just commented the things. So now I will read the file guys, actually fs.readfile synchronization. Firstly, I will read the file using sync methods. So I will just pass the file name, what I'm going to read. Yes guys, I've just read it, and I will store the data in a variable, that is const file data is equal to, yes, I've just created a variable. And I will console the data, whatever data is there, console.log, then file data. Okay, actually guys, as we all know that in my last videos, I have already clear you all that read file method to provide us the data in buffer format, which is a new data type for the Node.js. So guys, I will just use the UTF encoding just to get the data in a homogeneous form. And now I will console the thing, console.log, and I will just print end of file. Yes guys, I will save it. Okay guys, so what I have done, I have just required the fs module, and I have just read the file which is created earlier using the fs write file sync. Okay, and I have just using the encoding, that is UTF-8, because guys, fs provide us the data for, by default in a buffer data. Okay, so now I just print the data, and thus I have ended the file. I've just written this file. Actually guys, this line will tell us the difference between synchronous and asynchronous. Just watch this carefully. Okay guys, so I will just save it, and I will go to the command prompt, and I will read in my program. Yes, you can see guys, it is showing me welcome to Stubborn Developers, and then it's showing me end of file. Yes. Okay guys, so because of guys, I have just used the synchronization. Read file sync. I have just used the read file method synchronously. That's why what it has done. Firstly, it has complete the request, whatever I just given here. Then it has written the data or display whatever I have received, and then it is printing the end of file. Okay guys, so it is showing just synchronously guys. But now I will make a comment once again. I will just make a command just to understand asynchronous. Okay, so guys, now what I will do, I will just use fs.readfile. As you all know, I have already cleared you all in my last video just to use synchronous method, I would use read file sync, and just to use asynchronous, I have to just use read file. Then guys, firstly I have to provide the file name, that is test.txt. Yes guys. Then I have to provide the encoding. This is similar to the synchronous method actually, but it expects one more argument, that is a callback function, or we can say it's an arrow function. Okay, so in this callback function, first parameter will be error, and then second parameter will be file data. Okay, so now I will just console the file data here. Okay, I will just console the file data. I will console at the top console.log before function. Okay, so guys, you can understand that in previously I was just using read file sync, and then I will declare the variable, that is file data here. But in asynchronously, I have just to pass a callback function. In the callback function, I have just given two parameters. First one is the error, and another one is the file data. Okay, so guys, now I will run my program once again. Actually, guys, it's an example of asynchronous method. I will go to the command prompt, and I will rerun my program. Yes, guys, you can see what has been done. Okay, firstly, before function is called, then end of file is called, and in the very end, I have just got the welcome to Stubborn Developers. Okay, so guys, you can see what it has been done. Firstly, before function is called, then I just call a function just to read a file asynchronously. So guys, what it has been done, it has not stopped the processing of my current file. Actually, when I created a request here, then it is just created request, but it's not blocked my code execution till the end. So now, firstly, I got the before function, then I received the end of file. I just received end of file here because guys, this function didn't complete its job before the going to this line. Okay, so you can see guys, so this is the basically asynchronously in which we have not blocked our code before without execution. Okay, it has just let it go wherever our file is going to be at. Okay, so this is the basically difference between synchronous and asynchronous. Okay, in some cases guys, we have to use synchronously. Suppose that we have some code and that is related to this particular file, so we can't execute this code until or unless our code of this particular function is completed. So just to overcome with these problems, we have to use synchronous. And suppose we don't, our code that is written after the method is not dependent to this particular, then we can use asynchronous methods. So guys, both methods are very much important in the Node.js. Sometimes we have to use asynchronously just to fast some our speed. Suppose guys, I have just provide here lot of functions. I can just provide. Okay, so it will not block the code. It will just take a request, and then whenever request will be completed, it will just call the callback function, and it will just return the data, whatever it is. Okay guys, so I hope guys you understand the difference between synchronous functions and asynchronous functions. But guys, still if you have any problem regarding the synchronous or asynchronous methods, you can directly just ask me in the comment box, and I will get back to you as soon as possible. So guys, we will meet in the next video, and we will learn something new. So till that time, take care.